Welcome everyone. We have now a third session that is devoted to slide 18 and 19, that is middle class dynamics. I share immediately with you my PowerPoint. Right, as usual, it's a routine now. You have here some page, the PowerPoint here, and now middle class dynamics from the mid 1980s to recent times. That is replication of slide 18 and 19 in Jeanette Gornick's presentation. Here you have the graph. You see the poor, the rich, the affluent class, and the middle class income group over time in some, let's say, 15 countries. We try to do this, to do the same. So, for this introduction, the question of slide 18-19, middle class dynamics, we'll see the different concepts there, including the income class groups. Then how do we program that on statin? What is implementation on LISSY and exercise? Just to precise, this session is very close to session 16 because we make use almost of the same variables. The only one thing that changed is the last lines at the end of the loop of slide 16 and the very first line because we have 15 countries to consider. So the question is perfectly presented by Jeanette. What about the hollowing out of the middle? Is it general or is it special to some countries? What about the size of the middle income class group? Once again, slide 18-19, it's okay. So before we adopt the big concept, I propose you that we launch the program because we have, it's almost like in slide 16, but we have many countries, so we cannot do, we need time. So what I propose is we go and open the program we want to execute, Control C. After we create a new page where we, as usual, your login, your password, project list, package, stata, the routine, slide 18-19, and Control V. We launch, that's it, and we just wait. During the wait, yes, we depend on slide 16 programming. What is the big difference? It's simply the histograms for three group categorical variables, the poor, the affluent class, and middle income class group, that is between. We have 15 countries. Yes, this list is very clear. Two time periods, like in slide 16. And the big difference is that we have to define the median of the equalized disposable income. Let's call that MEDI if you want. Below 50% of the MEDI, you have the relative poverty group. Above 150% of the MEDI, you have the affluent class group, and in the bracket between, you have the middle class income group. And this means that if you have a look to the program, it's almost like slide 16, but we change things at the end of the program, including the end of the loop you can read on slide 16. We have suppressed the Gini calculation, because this is a way to earn some time. We then create three dummy variables for the poor, for the affluent group, and for the middle class group. And in this new loop here, we generate the dummy variables for the poor when EDI is lower than 50% of the median, the PAF, the affluent group when EDI is higher than 150% of the median, and your middle if you are neither PAF nor poor. Then, simply to obtain a table, you can have a look to the listing. We create class group, that is one for the poor, two for the middle class, and three for the PAF. And then we create a time variable, one for the old times, and two for the 2010-something, the most recent year available. And at the end of the day, we generate two horizontal bar histograms that are summing to 100% with the poor, the middle, and the affluent on the two dates. and we export this twice so that we have the result. For LISSY implementation, we have already done this, and as far as I remember, it's more than 4 minutes, but I will not correct. Let's try to reconnect. Recent jobs, after some minutes, LISSY disconnects, but anyway, we have our results, so slide 18 and 19. Repetition of our slides, then the listing, where, for instance, we have the income class groups generated here, and then the graphs. Those graphs, graph 1 for the past, graph 2 for the almost present, and just at I copy-paste this to the PowerPoint, and what we see here is the dynamics. The first funny thing is that we have more affluent people than poor people. It's simply because bracket definitions are not log symmetric to the with the median. So it means that if you could have different results if you define affluent group as more than 200% of the median. That is the log symmetric to relative poverty. It's just a joke. But what we see in this graph is that systematically everywhere, poverty increased almost everywhere, and affluent group increased in general, so that whatever the country, the median group declined. The lowest decrease is for Denmark, and it's a decrease by 1.6%, something like that. You should calculate this better. The interest of the rankings is to obtain, to see countries where the crunch of the middle had been stronger, like in Austria and certainly Belgium. And you see also the countries like Denmark and Australia, and Australia where the dynamics of middle class decline is not that strong. So, we have seen this. Important thing, Israel and the US are at the top. Nordic countries are more modest on middle class decline. Anyway, this trend of shrinking middle class well assessed in this group of countries, and the ranks helps detect the transformations. So you can add your comments and for your exercises. What about France? What happened there? Big question. Indeed, most of the transformation of France are in the 1980s. You can elaborate on the social policies of the 1980s in France. And then please add the Latin American countries just to have fun. So enjoy this series of programs and see the possibility for you to develop new interesting transformation. So thanks a lot. See you next session for a new replication of results, and have a good day. Thanks a lot. Bye.